cool stuff. We're going to have a lot of women's wrestling. And also our champion is defending her championship. That's Delilah Doom. Yeah! She's defending against Erica Torres. So, and, you know, we have a lot of surprises. We have a lot of local girls. And we have a lot of girls from California, too. And, of course, I have my twisted sister, Holiday, with me. She's over there. And we're going to go against the extra talented Aaron Solo and that guy called Ricky Stark. So that's some of the things that we're doing. I hope I can see you all there. Also, we're going to have Race. She's going to be part of, you know, a very interesting match for the to see who's going to face Delilah Doom on our next show in California.
The Twisted Sisters, the team of Holly Dead and Thunder Rosa.
For those who came for us, thank you so much. We appreciate your well spent money on merch and your support. And don't forget, we'll be back in Austin, Texas on the 13th. All women's wrestling, baby. Thank you so much, Sagi. Thank you so much, all the fans. And thank you, DWF.
Awesome.
Awesome.
You gotta buy. Hey, I'm gonna get you up and I'll be like, don't forget to buy your freaking tickets.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah,
we need to pay the girls.
Yeah, definitely. All
right. One girl right here. One girl right here.
So how do you feel about being part of, like, you know, Sabotage? And it's not all, like,
I'm so excited.
Female promotion, but it's.
It's about time they asked me. Seriously, about time. So I'm really excited. I've never been a part of an all female show, so that's. Amazing. That shows you how much female wrestling has progressed. The fact that there's an all-female show.
Yeah, and is it all female? Is there something like that ever done in Texas that you know?
In Texas, no. There's been promotions that have come here, like Shimmer. Mm-hmm. I think Shimmer came down here for WrestleMania, right? But when WrestleMania was here, they did like.
But not a like.
Maybe. I'm not really sure.
But I'm not talking about like a. But I mean, Shimmer can be considered like a. What would you say, bro? That's a mainstream, right? Yeah, major indie. Like, we are like bread and butter, you know,
yeah.
Like indie. But we're gonna be big. Yeah, but.
No, but it's true. That's true. I agree. That is the first promotion that you guys bring down here that's like that. Hell yeah.
So now you hear.
And I'm excited to be a part of it. Because that's freaking awesome.
And she's gonna go with.
It's a big movement.
I
saw that.
She's talking shit, but you're
going to the gym. I know, what the hell?
Can you pose for the camera?
Ooh.
Pose, like you pose on your selfie.
Oh, yeah. Wait a little bit.
How many posters? Like, how many is a lot? 100?
How many posters? Yeah, probably.
100? I don't know, we've just been chilling. You're going to be seeing me passing out flyers, you know. Promoting never ends, right, Mr. D? He never books me, by the way. That guy that never books me, that is gonna be booked in our
show.
That
is such a lie. She's so busy. If she stay in one place, she's all over the world. You're another Delilah Doom. Y'all just like, just go.
Hey,
look, ask her. I send her a message. I was like, hey, can you come work my show? I'm booked.
Boy, and remember, you gotta ask me like 3 months or 4 months
in advance. I gotta book her 4 months in advance and everything. All I know is, Sabotage, Rob Love, I'm going to whoop your ass. Whoopsie!
I'm in Anarchy Wrestling today. There's one of those times I have not come to a show and where I'm not booked or announced. So I'm working Alley Cat. Somebody got hurt, so now I'm gonna have a one-on-one. That's happened pretty often. I honestly just want to go home, but it's so much to do. But if I wouldn't come today, I wouldn't have some context for Sabotage. I got 2 interviews this week. I rented a car, so it's gonna be an adventure. Hopefully, I got a couple fans helping me out this week, and hope for the best. Hope for the best. The flowers she put. I'm gonna cry, man. This is fucking sad. She put it on Maggie. I gave her flowers yesterday. I mean, you guys can't see, but I went before I left. I went and got flowers for Maggie, and I should have gotten her something else. Because this is the second time that one of the fans, like a big fan, dies after I meet them. It's kind of weird. Yeah. The Muffin Man, that, like, the funny part is, like, the Muffin Man, he passed away. After this year, at the beginning of the year. He's from the East Coast. And the creepy thing, it was Holiday and I were on his profile picture. That was, like, the last time he went to a wrestling show. and Maggie was coming to watch Joey Ryan and me go on after wrestling, so it's not weird. I had to do that. This is a life, brother. I feel like, you know, like those people used to go and knock on your door to like sell you stuff. That's how I feel. Trying to sell a wrestling, all women's, predominantly all women's show.
Rumores, La Tropa F, A Castillo.
Hey, let me ask if I can put my thing in there.
He says no soliciting,
And also another thing that I learned is like, you gotta buy tape. Last time, I went with no tape and it was the stupidest thing I could ever done. That was like my first time I was posting flyers. That was for Stardom USA. I voy de pendeja sin pinche tape en ninguna parte voy a poner mi verga. Vámonos. Muchas gracias, mucho gusto. Que pase buen día. This is a good part of being bilingual. You can talk to everybody. Hey, ¿cómo está? Mucho gusto. Hey, nice to meet you. My name is Melissa Cervantes. I'm a professional wrestler. There you go. Hey, mi nombre es Melissa Cervantes. Soy luchadora profesional. Trabajo para la compañía Lucha Underground. No me han visto, pues véanme en Netflix, putos. Órale. You don't say that. You do it. Do you know the worst part of having the biggest foot in the world?
What?
It's like you buy basketball shoes and you look like a fucking, like a hobbit. I look like a hobbit. It sucks. I don't think
I've put this up
yet. Oh man, feels good here, huh?
Yes.
Jimmy's been really helpful. Like I know a lot of people have heat with him, but he's always been super nice to me and like I'm super appreciative of like him. He's teaching me a lot. I mean, you never know who you're gonna learn from, you know? Like he's like telling me like, oh, you gotta put flyers here, you gotta go here, make sure you don't waste your time in these places, nobody goes there. I mean he runs another type of show, but you know he's super willing to help, which I appreciate that. The same with Marty, like that's the first time I met him, I was asking him like 50,000 questions and he was willing to help, so honestly why not? Is that the
Voodoo Donuts.
Cause I can call a little Ruru. He's, but the thing is like he said that he will let me, cause he has connects with the army bases that mm-hmm. we can do something.
Yeah.
You know? I just need to go to work out, man. Like,
yeah.
No matter what, I'm gonna hit traffic regardless.
Yeah, no matter.
Or no, I should go home and then strategize for tomorrow. What do you think?
And you can make a better plan.
Yeah. So I can go like, okay, I went here from here to here, and then tomorrow I will go to here, here. Cause she wants to help, so I need to like, she's a champion, so I can drive her around.
Mm-hmm.
Now I like for people to see her. And she can be wearing the fucking championship belt. It's like people work, you know, ain't people like me.
Yeah,
this is my life.
Mm-hmm.
I go with her tomorrow in San Antonio, and then San Marcos, I can focus that in that area. But then I still have to come here cause I have to train.
Mm-hmm.
Something. I don't know, but I think we should dig on this right here. What do you think?
Yes.
I gotta eat too.
Homemade chicken salad, brother.
It's been in a backpack. How many hours?
Dude, shut up. A lot. Hey, still good, brother. For the love of God, please be good. I need to get it. I should have gotten it. It's still cold.
He said it all excited. It's still cold. It's good.
It's good, bro. It's good. If we sell the 60 times 25 that's $1,500, that's $1,300, and I need $500 more. Now I don't want to spend no more money, and I would have rather have it outside, but it's going to cost us $1,000 more, which I do not have.
Which, I mean, we could do it outside, but honestly, you wouldn't be able to regulate anything without having a fence.
Yes, and that's something that I need to see. Because the setting this is, I'm more of a thing for a concert than for a wrestling event. I mean, I like being sitting here and like watching the action over there. But it's like, it's going to be a little odd because it's not, because you guys have the stage here. And we don't have screens. Unless we're going to use the screen.
Well, that'll be on the TV. Yeah, I mean, we do have cameras we can position down onto the ring where it'll project up here on these TV screens. And the ones downstairs.
I think it will be smart if we do that.
Yeah.
It is what it is. I'm not gonna stress a lot.
I mean, again, we've had wrestling in here before.
How many people did you had in that show?
Attendance wise?
Yes, attendance wise.
I want to say that it was around 200, 250, somewhere in there. And they had a lot of people on stage when they had structured that way before. Because there'll be some folks that are wandering around that'll be happy, but they'll be like, man. If I could spend another $20 or whatever to get up there on stage, and I'll do it right now. That happens all the time when we have events similar to this with like the different VIP areas and stuff like that. We had a Magic Mike show back in February, and every other girl that came through was like, yeah, our tickets are cool, but we want to be like on stage, so
here's another $20.
I'm like, okay,
What other ways do you think is good for us to like, promote the show besides the... I've been posting posters everywhere pretty much. Mm-hmm. 7th Street, 6th Street, hitting different places in San Antonio, San Marcos, here. What else do you think
it's good? I've seen sponsored posts from you guys online too, so I know you are doing social stuff as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's good. I mean, I know concerts and wrestling are different, and to be honest with you, I don't know the best ways to target wrestling fans, like, other than just using the same platforms. Like, I think everything you're doing is solid. There's always the option of radio, but it's expensive, and you never know, when they're going to play. Like, can't guarantee what time slots unless you dump a shit ton of money into radio. I say just keep doing what you're doing, honestly.
Yeah. I mean, I just don't know what else to do, since it's, like, our first show ever here, and we're, like, not even from Texas, so.
Right.
And then it's women's wrestling. It's not like, men's wrestling.
I don't know.
I mean, the potentially is more, it's more appealing for non-wrestling fans because it's women,
I mean, I saw the poster and I was like, oh, shit. All right, yeah. Cool.
Extra.
At the door.
On top of the...
Yes. If not, it's going to be a total...
Loss.
Yes, and I cannot take that. Because if we take that, it's gonna take me fucking 2 months to make up this money.
Play guitar,
please. At this point, I'm shitting on my pants right now. I don't wanna lose that much money. Like, that's my main thing. I know it's wrestling, sometimes we win, sometimes we lose. It's a big thing that we're, it's a big risk we're all taking. But if we want to make this successful, we have to push. We gotta get our assets and put it all together. Like, that's the only thing we can do now. The people don't show up, they don't show up. They buy the tickets, that's not our problem. We need to sell tickets. That's what it comes down to. And it's a fucking awesome venue too, So, at the end of the day, this is money for them. And merch sales, because if they have their fans come and they have new shit, they can get the new shit. For me, it's money for me to run more shows to hook them, At the end of it, for me, it's for them.
Everybody helping out.
Pretty much, but they don't see it that way. They don't see it as that. Listen. I know that. I'm so weirded out because in Cali it's different, but I guess, like, every territory is different, and that's
right.
What we have
people
to learn.
Are gonna buy it.
I've got to
get chill.
The only
place I've ever seen that's like
selling out
way in advance is
relatively. Well, but they have like, Indian Underground.
Yeah.
But that's like, we can't compare ourselves from Wrestle Circus.
That's what
yet.
I'm saying, so that's not a fair assessment. If you ask TCW and ask them how their pre-sales go, I guarantee they probably didn't even sell 29 tickets. They probably sold like 10.
Post it. At this point, post it.
Yeah, because she was like, I'm going to send you something else.
I need something now. At this point, I need something now.
Yeah, because she's like, I'm going to send something else. So,
like, right. If we wait, that's going to be a day before the show. No, we need something now. We had November, December, January, February, March, April, 6 months, man. 6 months. This is the reason why people don't believe in what the fuck we're doing, because people don't care about it so much, because people are not passionate about it. Mm. You know? If you want to get to WWE, if you want to be seen, you gotta do it. You gotta do the work, you know? Mm-hmm. This shit doesn't sell alone. Like, this promotion took years or months or whatever to get their fan base. But if you don't do anything to get a fan base, we're not gonna go anywhere. No, this is how passionate I am about what I'm doing, you know? It's like...
I like it.
I like it. You get both seals of approval.
No, it's like a perfect example. Medusa, she has her new podcast. She's Medusa. She could be like, whatever. She's got posted. I have fans. No, she goes and writes, hey guys, I have like my things dropping today. You should watch it. If not, I'm gonna beat your ass. You know. She's still doing that because she knows what's up. You know. Oh, she is. Who else does that? Like. Is Sammy tells when his shit drops on YouTube and stuff?
On Twitter, he's like, hey, I just put this video out.
People are not gonna know you drop something if you...
And then whenever we have him on the show, he's always like, hey, I just dropped a video yesterday or whatever it is.
And then even on his YouTube videos, he'll put like little clips sometimes of the podcast on there. Yeah, and he'll put the logo and everything.
Make sure y'all check out my podcast on Hill Freaks Wrestling.
He'll do it like, you know, once every couple of weeks or so, just real quick.
Yeah, I mean, it just doesn't take that long, man.
Most of Texas on your neck, get down.
Like the lips like J.R. Smith has.
Oh, God. That's like the most,
yeah, turn it up.
Yeah,
what is that?
You're welcome. I made that happen.
Now?
Look at that.
That is so sweet. And you know what? Even if we lose money, the beautiful country of the United States give me a good returns. But I don't really want to use that money for that. I was walking, posting on flyers, and I just like, my shirt was drenched, and I'm just like,
yeah.
I had clothes on in the car. I didn't even care. I just like took my clothes in the middle of the street, changed. Wipe myself off to the next one. Then I was like, this is too much. Hey. I got nothing to show anyways.
Most people don't know. Like, yeah, you topless in the city of Austin. They're like, huh.
That's gonna be my next one. Be like, she's crafty, you could go topless in Austin. On the other side too.
Damn. It looks so pretty. We're like the most
very colorful.
Colorful.
Mm-hmm. That's what I was going for.
I was gonna say everything colorful else is like death metal. Out.
Exactly. And even with like wrestling posters, like everything's kinda always like dark black like and red. Way. Yeah, so I just want color.
I'm on the top.
There you go.
I'm on the top in there.
Yeah,
that's me.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Very cool.
And I'm also on Lucha Underground.
What are we doing? We're setting a ring up?
Right on. Yeah. Get down,
boy.
You're gonna get body
slammed. Wait, what day?
In the middle of the ring.
Am I gonna be here?
You better May be May 13th.
Well, I just made sure I tour for a living.
So. May 13th.
Yeah, I'll definitely
be here. And yet, no, is this really big for me and for my husband? This is our first show ever in Texas.
Well, I mean, you are based in California.
California, right? Yeah. So, and this is our third show, you know, so we're like jumping from like starting and then like, oh, we're going to go to another state. So I'm kind of shitting my pants.
But some people solid on the ground that are helping out. So, I mean, yeah. I think everyone's going to run smooth. It's going to be cool. I'll make sure everyone's taken care of.
Yeah,
it's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be fun. I mean, I'm already having fun. I've been here the whole week passing out flyers and talking to people, so. Nice. Everybody's really nice. I was actually surprised. I was like, they let me post posters everywhere. Cali, they're like, no thanks. Like, fuck off. And I'm like, shit. Yeah, I'm like, here's.
Well, if y'all get a while here and y'all wanna come back out to the show tonight, see the place in action, get a feel for the bartenders, get a feel for, you know, people in the building, kind of see how things flow. Swing back by.
All right.
I'll send you a text to you guys.
All right, sir. All right. Very nice to meet you.
Sure, I
could use a drink. Thank you. What do you want to record?
There's a taco truck literally across the street in that little parking lot.
All right, that's real good.
Oh, you want to do something?